Hi there. Okay, so I just recorded a whole live video with the volume off. Thank you for joining. This is hilarious, but I am about to do this live again because the message is important and I'm doing it tonight. So if you don't know me, hi, I'm Shauna K. Lester. I'm just checking. Okay, great. The volume is working now and we're going to do this properly. If you joined over on Instagram, thank you. If you didn't and you're on Facebook, great. We're going to have this conversation again right now. If you're watching it on the replay, thank you for tuning in. So, what I wanted to talk about and what I just spoke about while the volume was not working is about the personal statement. And we were talking about basically IMGs approaching this personal statement, underestimating the importance of it, specifically thinking that it will not make a difference in their match outcome. So it's like I have spoken with people who their thing is, I know that there are all of these program directors who've been reading for 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, they've been reading for very long times. So it's impossible that me now that I'll come along and I'll write something that they have never read before. This is not possible for me to write something that they've never read before. Therefore, I'm just not going to place a lot of importance on my personal statement. I get that comment in various forms. So, there are some people who genuinely feel like, maybe I could have something to say, but I'm not exactly sure what I will say, so we need to kind of figure it out. But there are also people who genuinely believe that it's not possible for them to write something that will make them stand out at all. And so, the way that this manifests itself when you feel like you can't write anything that will make you stand out is primarily in procrastination, in waiting till the very last minute to start your personal statement. And so, what I was explaining is that we are essentially in the middle of June, going toward the end of June. You need to have this personal statement for September. You either should have already written your personal statement or be writing your personal statement right now. But if you're somebody who you believe that, hey, it's not possible for me to write something that's going to make much of a difference, what happens is that you procrastinate on putting together that personal statement, right? And so then the whole thing ends up being a rushed process. The other way that it manifests itself, which that one is very obvious to anyone who reads your personal statement, is the lack of introspection in the personal statement. So to you, it's not going to make a huge difference anyway, so you hurriedly write something, and that's definitely connected to procrastination. Because you procrastinate, you hurriedly write something, and then what you prepare as your personal statement shows a lack of introspection. So it's very surface information, saying things like, I want to go and I want to do residency because I want to improve my knowledge and skills. I want to increase my knowledge and skills. Rest assured that everybody else who is applying to residency is saying that they want to improve their knowledge and skills. That's not a sufficient description of why you need to match into residency, especially if you're an IMG. There needs to be something else and something substantial that is driving you. So saying that it's knowledge and skills is not sufficient. You really want to do the introspection to be able to tell people what is it about the specialty that fulfills you more than other things? What is it about it that makes you feel like it's something you can do for the rest of your life? What were the turning points in your medical studies that made you feel like this is something you want to do? As an international medical graduate, you don't ever want to leave anything up to chance, but especially for people who are you're on that borderline where other things about your application aren't particularly amazing or excellent. You don't have like some trailblazing, amazing record from medical school. Your scores, like they'll open the gate, they're average or above average, but they're also not amazing. This is an extremely important component of your application. It is a really unique opportunity for you to distinguish yourself in the process, for you to set yourself apart, period. But especially if nothing else is setting you apart, you want to pay attention to the personal statement and not just like dismiss it as something that, hey, it's not going to help me much anyway. For some of you, it probably will be the only thing that manages to do that. And another reason why it can do that is because it is uniquely the thing that speaks for you in your own voice, right? If you have a strong MSPE, you want to make sure you have that. You want to guide your people who are writing your letters of recommendation so that you have strong LORs. But at the same time, the personal statement becomes the thing that you can speak for yourself in your own voice, right? And so you want to make use of that opportunity. The other way that things manifest itself when you don't think that your personal statement will make a huge difference is this lack of your personal story. So as I was saying, it's to you, it's like to you, that personal story doesn't carry any weight. It doesn't carry any great importance. And so you don't even bother to communicate it. So what happens is that your personal statement ends up being more of a regurgitation of your CV, more of a regurgitation of your resume, of like, you know, whatever you have, but it ends up being more like, okay, here are my professional things that I have achieved. Here's what I want to do. Here are the skills that I want to have, because one day I want to work in this subspecialty. And there's a complete absence of, well, who are you as a person? What are the things that you value? What are your character, you know, strengths? Why would I want you in my program, both as a professional and as a human being? And there's nothing that's going to help people to connect to you more strongly than your story, more than showing them the path that you've been on, those moments of realization. You can call them your aha moments. What are those things that woke you up to knowing that you wanted to do residential training in this particular specialty? What are those patient interactions that are giving birth to that, right? Or what are the patient interactions that gave birth to that? But if you don't believe that you can write something that makes you stand out, if you're approaching this with the mindset of, okay, this is a part of the application, I just need to get it done, I just need to not mess up, I just need to be good enough to not, you know, sabotage my chances with the personal statement, but the personal statement itself won't make a difference, you will not put this emphasis on your personal story. So earlier in the week, I had done a video in the Minute to Match series that I do, where I focus on like quick strategies and tips. And I spoke about the fact that you don't actually need to have an extraordinary, you don't need to have extraordinary experiences to have an extraordinary personal statement, right? It's more how you use certain tools to put together your personal statement that will make the difference. And I focused on clarity and I focused on anecdotes. No. If you haven't taken the time, as I spoke about earlier, with the procrastination and the lack of introspection that shows up in the personal statement, if you haven't allotted enough time to do the introspection that's needed to write a strong statement, that shows up in the lack of clarity, that shows up in the lack of a main message that people can latch onto and be like, okay, this person wants to do this for that reason. It shows up in the paragraphs that don't flow together, in the messages that are choppy all over the place. I remember, you know, one person from last year, I was so overwhelmed. Like, by the time I got to paragraph 2 reading the draft, I felt as if I was drowning. And I'm not even being dramatic. It just felt like I walked in a door and somebody just threw like one bucket of information on me, and they threw another bucket of information on me, and they threw like two more buckets of information on me in the space of 5 minutes. There was no clarity. It was just jumping all over the place from I got this grade in med school and I did well on this, and then now I want to do that, and I traveled here and I served people. You could tell the person was just saying all of the things that they felt that they should be saying, but there was no real introspection as to like, what are my values? What are the things that have really made me know that I can dedicate my life to this? What's the difference I want to make once I come out of residence? Just very basic questions that everybody needs to answer, but like answered from your perspective in life, right? When you don't do that introspection, it shows up in your lack of clarity. And if your personal statement is not clear, and people have their pick of candidates to choose from, that is just not going to work in your favor, right? It's not, I mean, maybe if you have like 250s, you know, like just, you know, everything is nice and bright and shiny and your scores are off the chart or higher, you can afford to do that. But if that's not you, you can't afford to not have a main message and to not be clear. And when you don't place any value on your actual personal story, on your story, on sharing that with people because you think it won't matter, then you have a lack of using the other tool that I spoke about that you can use to be memorable, which is anecdotes. You just don't have strong anecdotes. You don't have anecdotes from key turning points in your life at all. They're just not there because even you don't think they're important. So why would you share them with someone else, right? So you want to just, first of all, get it straight in your mind that not only can you, that would be the mindset switch. To not think that you can't write something that is memorable or that a PD hasn't read before, but that you actually must write something that a PD and that these people who are reading have not read before. And then the other mindset shift would to stop thinking that you need to have done something amazing in order to write that thing that would be memorable, and to realize that you just really need a key set of tools in order to do that correctly. So I had explained also in the first video, if you're just joining, hi and thanks for joining, we had to trash that because the volume wasn't working. I had explained in that video actually that I talk with clients normally after their interview, so when they're done, and every year I get really good feedback from people who take the time to, you know, they allot enough time to do the writing, they do the introspection, they realize that not only can they be memorable in their personal statement, but that they must be. And that resonates with people because effort shows. As a person, you know, even outside of the personal statement, you can identify with the fact that when somebody is lazy, that shows. When somebody does thorough work, it cannot help but show up. If somebody takes the time to really look into themselves and to really think about how they're communicating their motivation for residency, it will show up on the paper and people will resonate with that. So my favorite feedback of all time is the candidate, the client who came back, and she told me that the program director, she matched into family, told her that they called her to interview because of one sentence in her personal statement. Not even the whole thing, a single sentence, right? And that was a sentence that we came up with together shortly before she came off the phone at the end of one of our consultations. It's just something that she said in passing. And I said to her, what? Because I couldn't believe she had done that thing. It's a non-medical thing, but it's a really cool, like, funky life experience thing. I was like, really? That happened? And we ended up working it into her personal statement. And the PD told her that that's why he wanted to talk with her. That one sentence was the reason. And from this year, because that kind of stuff happens all the time, but that one is just my favorite because it's kind of just something that she said, like, randomly, you know, like when people start talking after the camera's off, she just said it randomly and it made all the difference. But this year too, I think my favorite from this past match here was someone who she explained to me that she actually felt so uncomfortable because the PD walked in with a room, into a room with other applicants, and basically just said it out loud that he was looking for her because of something that she had said in her personal statement about a country, you know, that she's from, and he had been there and had lived there, and he just wanted to talk with her. And of course she is happily matched. So when somebody is looking for you because of something you wrote, that's something that they haven't read before, and that's something that they remember. So just make sure that you accept that that's something that can be done for you and you can do it. All right. So take care. If you're still sitting your exams, all the best with that. But we're going to have no procrastination, so you're going to start early. There isn't going to be a lack of introspection, so you're going to do your introspection. And there isn't going to be coming from you, you are not going to submit a personal statement that is basically a regurgitation of your CV. You are going to have a personal statement that balances the personal and the professional, and that makes people really feel like they know your story because you told your story using the different writing tools that can make you memorable. All right, good luck and thanks for tuning in. If you're catching this on the replay, also thanks for tuning in, and I'll be back with another live next week. Bye.